This will be in this space, and some of the music I'm going to play is pretty loud, so I'm hoping it's not going to be too much vicious. Wow. Okay, so this is Amanda Feary. She wrote a piece called Rattle, 2010. And she's written another piece called Star Maker, which I will play tonight. It's the first time it's being performed. Rattle I've played many times, and I will start with that, and then I will play Star Maker. And I look forward to 2020, when we're going to have a third piece of what I would say is a triptych, but perhaps that's not the right... Is it a triptych?
Yeah,
it's like Francis Bacon triptych or something. Anyway, this is a really fun piece called Rattle, and I'm going to read what Amanda said about it, because I think this does give us some idea. Oh, did you say about it? So, in 2010 I wrote Rattle, a memory piece about my clarinet lessons, particularly elements of the lessons I was least excited about. Work on intonation, scales, melodious studies, and removing erroneous breaks and squawks. 5 years later, I thought I would continue the memory trail and go back to my earliest lessons when I wasn't allowed to play any melodies until I managed to get an actual sound and pleasant tone out of the clarinet. Star Maker deals with the battle between weekly lessons, instrumental technique, and a child just eager to have a bit of a mess around with a brand new instrument. There's another piece in 2020. I'm not sure where in the memory trail that will lie. So, I'm going to do them. Would you prefer Star Maker first?
I had the idea that Rattle would be first.
So that's what I have.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Let's have Rattle.
Thank you.
Bennett. Ed Bennett is from Bangor, County Down, and he wrote this piece in 2005. And what's really great from my point of view, because I play a lot of contemporary music, and quite often you don't get to play the pieces very often, and sometimes you're quite happy not to play them quite often, actually, to be perfectly honest. But there are many others who would wish to play more often, and this is one of these pieces I've played a lot. So it's really great, I can just take it out and play it without doing any practice, practically. But I did do a lot of practice when I learned it first. So, I hope it doesn't fall off the stand. Monster is for bass, clarinet and electronics, and so there's a backing track with it on CD, which has lots of different sounds on the track, as you'll hear, and some of them are actually bass clarinet sounds on the track, but you won't necessarily know that they're bass clarinet sounds because they're all kind of mashed up. I think it's going to fall off. Okay. Usually you have page turners, but maybe I need a page flattener or something. Okay. I'll get another one of those. I need to stop lunch as well, otherwise I get completely lost. On the backing track here, you'll hear a lot of different sounds. One of them, you'll hear is a lingophone of German, because at the time the composer, Ed Bennett, was back and forth to Berlin. He was living in Berlin, and he was trying to learn German, so he decided to include some of that in the track. So at certain points you'll hear some German words in it too. And at the end then, there's a bit that kind of was a bit mental, and it's supposed to sound like somebody having a nervous breakdown, so that was fine. Okay. Yep.
Thank you. Thank you.